Afternoon. How we doing? How's the Saints?
I thought they were like in the playoffs. No?
Oh, everybody's in the playoffs in the South. Is that what you're saying? You're in? Not so much. All right. Well, thanks for being here. Obviously, we've been following the signing day. And look, it takes a village, right, to put together a year-long, sometimes 18 months. But for me, we'll go with the year because that's how long I was here in putting this class together. And it starts with evaluation and then the recruitment. And the evaluation starts out of our player personnel office. Will Redmond and his staff did a great job in the evaluation. And then it immediately goes into the recruiting element, and that's J.R. Belton and his staff have done an incredible job. And, you know, personnel, our staff recruiting, our students, our creative staff, Ryan, Gus, Eli, Brandon, they've done an incredible job. Our recruiting coordinator, Brian Polian, certainly the coaching staff, right? They've got to be out on the road, the analysts. Look, compliance is involved in this. Academics, support staff, sports medicine, Bo's team, development. I could go on and on. It takes a village. When you're doing recruiting weekends, you know, we're showing them, you know, why they should come to LSU. And putting together a collaborative, cohesive, high-performance staff is everybody working together. This is why you should come here for your development. So all of those groups coming together and working collaboratively together, they've done a great job, and I just wanted to take this opportunity to thank them and putting together an outstanding class. And so when we talk about the class, certainly we're talking about freshmen. You know, there's a lot of talk about the portal and, you know, tampering and all those things. Look, I don't get involved in worrying about those things. We focus strictly on recruiting to LSU the players that we want here, that we believe that will be successful here and that we can develop. And that's our mindset. We can't worry about what other schools are doing or what other teams are doing, what the hearsay is out there. We focus strictly on the job at hand, and that is recruiting those that we believe understand our mission to graduate champions. And the 25 that we've signed, we are super excited about. And I know personally I've gotten a chance to spend a lot of time with each one of them. And again, as I said earlier, and have said consistently since I've taken the job, we've got to pull our base. And, you know, 10 of them are from the state of Louisiana. They're also part of a very talented group of players from this state. I think when we look at it, I think of the top players, I think 8 of them are you know, top 15 players here in the state of Louisiana. And we stayed in an SEC footprint for the most part. You know, 21 of the 25 signees are from SEC, from the SEC footprint. We did move nationally because of our brand recognition. We're in Maryland, Minnesota, Nevada, and Ohio. But again, this is an SEC footprint. You know, the rating of classes, my other guys worry about that, recruiting personnel. They get million-dollar bonuses for that stuff. I don't, so I let them worry. Is it a million? So, I think if it's a top three, you get a million. You better get busy. Come up with a couple of names real quick. But, you know, obviously they did an incredible job in terms of where it ranks nationally. And then the position breakdown. You know, we're looking for pretty good balance on offense and defense, which I think we've gotten. And certainly, look, you know, you're always looking for players to impact immediately. But this is a class that I believe that when we recruit them, what we're asking them to do is immediately impact LSU football. And that means represent LSU in a positive way in the classroom, in the community, and as it relates to football. So be ready to compete immediately. As I mentioned, these are freshmen, players that we're excited about developing in the classroom, in our community, and certainly on our football field. On Friday, we will list a number of players that we've recruited out of the transfer portal. We won't do that today. This is, to me, this is about our freshmen, and this is their day. They've earned it. We'll talk about those that we've added through the transfer portal, which we had a need there as well, and that will be on Friday. So just to give us an overview of the players and the class itself, you know, we broke it down really by, you know, positional groups. And if you look at, you know, certainly starting with, you know, offensive linemen, you know, in-state was really big for us in terms of getting in-state players. You know, Tyree Adams, obviously, out of St. Augustine, a really big get for us, and a guy that we're excited about. And Lance Hurd, obviously, Monroe, and another Louisiana kid that we're certainly excited about. You know, if you go down the list in terms of DJ Chester out of Eagles Landing, a big athletic offensive lineman, again, that we think can come in. These are guys that we believe can impact us on the offensive line right away with some turnover that we're going to have. Paul Mubenga is an outstanding prospect, great school, comes from a Georgia powerhouse in Buford High School that I believe is somebody that can compete you know, plug in right away. So, you know, from an offensive line standpoint, I think, you know, we really did our due diligence in terms of finding the right guys that can impact. So as you look at each group, offensive line, defensive back, you know, running back, adding two from the state here at the running back position, you know, obviously with Trey Holly and Caleb Jackson, that's a huge need for us. So we could go down the list with Shelton Sampson, obviously out of Catholic High School, another outstanding addition to our program. I'll be happy to talk about each one of these guys individually. I think it's hard for me to go through each one of them. I'll be here for 45 minutes. But suffice to say that I think we looked at it by position group and the needs that we have. And look, you'll get a better sense, you know, I think, you know, when we get to the bowl game, you know, how we've managed the roster and what the roster looks like and how this all kind of makes sense and comes together for you. So with that, we'll shoot questions at you. Or you shoot them at me, I guess.
Ryan, if you wouldn't just how did things change from when you arrived here last December and you're trying to put, you know, scramble and put together a class to now this past year that you've had to show people what your vision is, show them success, and put together maybe a class maybe that you want to fill the needs that you have?
Yeah, I think first of all, getting to know the families and the individuals so much better. You know, I think there were a couple of the freshmen last year that, you know, I didn't even get a chance to meet the parents until they came on campus, you know, when they dropped their sons off. And that's not the way to recruit, obviously, but it was what it was. This recruiting has been great in the sense that they've been over my home. I've been in their home. They've been on campus several times. So you get a connection. And that, for me, in a recruiting standpoint, is that I'm going to know their son and be able to take care of their son. And that's what they want. So when we're talking about these players, could they transfer? Sure. But you feel so much more confident that you've made the right choices and they've made the right choices, that LSU is the right place for them. And they're not here under false pretenses or a quick sell, or that you're selling a used car to them, that you're really selling the right vision for them as to why they're here.
Hey, Coach, we were at Shelton Sampson signing, and his mother spoke to us and said getting a degree is just as important, if not more so, than the football. You've been on the road a year now talking about graduate champions. How much is that resonating with the parents you speak to and the student-athletes you're recruiting?
So much better than I had originally thought. And look, I think everybody's of the same opinion that if after your third season of competition, you're a first-round draft pick, we're not going to say, hey, come back, you know, and get your degree. But during that time, let's do everything possible to get to that degree. Let's use the summer. Let's use the time that we have here in between the semesters to add on to your degree. Let's not use that time to catch up or because we were a poor student that we've got to make up, you know, ground. And that's been a change here, that we're rewarding those guys so they can get closer to their degree. So when they get to their third year, let's walk out of here after 3 years, if it's 3 years, and you've got a degree and you're, you know, obviously a top draft pick.
Coach, just looking at your board, five of them are 45 minutes, you know, in a circle here. Just what does that say about the talent that this area has to offer? I know it's one of the lures
sure.
that brought you here.
Yeah, it's unmistakable in a sense that, you know, first of all, that they're so committed to LSU, right? They grew up LSU fans. That doesn't mean you can't recruit or you shouldn't recruit them as hard as everybody else. Matter of fact, I think we recruited them as well, if not better, because of that. We wanted to make sure that there was no stone unturned with our local players as well, that we did as well as if you were from Texas or Ohio. But there's such a, you know, as the flagship university, there's such a passion for LSU, and it's seen by such strong high school football in this particular area.
Hey, Coach, right here. Just, you know, you've talked a lot this year about how it was important for you guys to get younger at a lot of positions. You certainly see that O-line, secondary, tight end. How much of that, is just the confidence you have in your player development in terms of, you know, getting these guys ready and the importance of bringing in these younger guys and having them, you know, prepared well?
Yeah, I think it's a great question. I think we saw that this year, that we could play some freshmen and compete at the highest level. And that confidence level obviously has allowed us to look at freshmen and say, you know what, we can play freshmen. Do we want to have freshmen across the board? Probably not. We would like to be a little bit more veteran, if you will. And I will be quite frank with you, is that there are some position groups that we need to help out, if you will, through the transfer portal with more veteran players. But that doesn't mean that we're going to stunt the growth of a particular position group because we're bringing in somebody from the transfer portal. We're still going to let them compete, and the best players will play. But I love your question because I think we gained so much more confidence this year, and I did, in seeing Emery and Will in particular and Mason go out and certainly Harold go out and compete as freshmen at a high level.
Yeah, Brian, on this recruiting class, how many do you expect to be early enrollees? And if you have some, will they participate in any bowl practice at all?
Good question. Early enrollees, do we have that? I don't see it on my list. 15? So 15 of them will be early enrollees. And I chose not to include them in the bowl practice because I think it really would have detracted from our preparation. It would have been much more of a public relations show, more so than truly getting them ready. We're staying away from that. But we have a number of guys, as you mentioned, 15 of them that will come in early, not to mention, we're going to be anywhere from, it looks like, 8 to 10 maybe 8 to 10 in the transfer window. So you're talking about 23 mid-year enrollees.
Hey, Coach. You guys have a number of safeties, three of them in total. Do you think any of them could maybe help you guys out as a nickel corner or even a strike corner? Like, is there sort of versatility with those guys?
No, I think we've addressed it. You know, we feel really comfortable when recruiting has completed, and it hasn't completed totally for us yet. We feel like we're going to be to the numbers that we wanted to be at the cornerback position. So is there a little bit of flexibility there? Yeah, absolutely. I think, you know, we know that there's great flexibility with Ryan Yates as a guy that can play corner and safety. I know there's some flexibility even with some players on our roster. But We feel good about the numbers that will be reflected, as we get into, we're gonna have a recruiting weekend in January, and that one recruiting weekend in January will probably be where we kind of finish off our recruiting for this recruiting cycle.
Hey, Coach, I have two questions. The first one, with Kamori and Pimpton, you've coached a lot of tight ends over the years. Just his raw attributes, catch radius, what he did as a senior, how does it kind of stack up to all the tight ends you've evaluated over time?
I don't know that I've had somebody with his raw athletic ability. And certainly there's work to be done as it relates to the physicality of the position and whether he's going to be an inline. We want to develop our tight ends as complete tight ends, where they can do everything, where they're not just a guy that you can, split out. We want them to be able to get in there and be part of a blocking scheme as well. So, and he's committed to that, and that's the one thing that, we talk about developing tight ends. My background in developing Coach Dembrock is incredible in the number of tight ends that he's developed. We wanted that for him, and that resonated with him. And then, obviously, the other skills that he brings, you just can't teach, right? I mean, as you mentioned, his catch radius, his ability to win in one-on-one matchups is going to be exciting to be able to develop.
And then with Deshaun Womack, I mean, he probably played some of the stiffest high school competition of any of these signees and put up pretty gaudy numbers. Where does he kind of rank in terms of the guys that y'all hope can help out right away next year?
Yeah, so, obviously a team that, their rivalry game is IMG, It's a pretty good caliber of competition week in and week out. But he does. He fits the jack position for us, obviously with BJ going to the NFL. There's a natural opening there, on our roster. And we think he's a guy that can come in immediately and compete for playing time.
Coach, Aaron Lee, WGNO in New Orleans. We were with Tyree Adams this morning at St. Aug, and he talked about wanting to come in and play tackle, guard, center. It really didn't matter. Where do you see him actually fitting in? And he also used Will Campbell and Emory Jones as motivation for seeing their success and wanting to choose LSU.
Well, first of all, he's a great kid, and as you know, you got a chance to meet him. He's got great energy and comes from a great program. So I think what I love about him is there is some, flexibility. He can play guard. He can play tackle. He moves really well. I just think that, when we were looking at the in-state talent at that position, he was a guy that early on we felt like his best football, he hadn't even come close to scratching the surface. So we're excited about developing him and certainly a guy that could play multiple positions.
Coach, you mentioned J.R. Belton and his group and how vitally exceptional they are. Talk about how that department has expanded over the last decade or so in numbers, and then what does that mean to the position coaches, assistant coaches, what they used to do a decade ago, what those guys help them now? How you on Saturday you said it was a big deal. You like being this busy because you feel you got the personnel to take advantage of it where other people might not.
Yeah, no doubt. I think it's the creative piece and then obviously the ability to communicate on a day-to-day basis. So let's take the creative piece. Certainly the ability to reach the target audience is so important. And out of the recruiting office, whether it be graphics or social media, however we can reach our target audience, our recruiting office sets the table for that. And that's such a huge, I think, piece off the coach's shoulders to be able to do that, as well as organize and be creative when you come on campus, looking at different events so it doesn't become stale when you come on campus and you can't keep seeing Mike the Tiger every time. Mike the Tiger's awesome, but you've got to be creative in doing different things, and I think that comes with the creativity of a recruiting office that is now as expansive as I've seen in college football. And then I think the final piece of that is that logistically, when you come on campus, the ability to interact with the families. Let's not forget that. You can show them around on campus and be creative and reach out to the players, but sooner or later, you've got to bring everybody together. And I think they've done a great job with all of those facets of when they leave here, they feel like it's a family atmosphere, and that's what our recruiting department's done.
Coach, if I could ask you about the bowl preparation, I understand you're getting to Orlando like a week before the game, right? You're 27th?
Yeah, we're going to fly out on the 27th. That's correct.
Okay. So what's your approach? You want them to have fun? This is a reward for their season. How do you balance that with preparing for the game?
Yeah, I really want to do both. I want them to enjoy the opportunity that they have provided for themselves by being in the Citrus Bowl. So we're going to give them a day to enjoy and then, you know, gradually work themselves back into locked in for game week preparation. So that's why we took a little bit more time down there so we could do both. But we will get locked into a normal routine of preparation. So this week has been treated as if we were playing on Saturday. So we've gone through a traditional week of preparation for Purdue. So in reality, we've put everything in that we're going to do in game-like situation. And we'll duplicate that when we get to the bowl site. So we'll mix both, give them a chance to enjoy their time. They've earned it. But as we get further into the week, we'll lock down and focus on Purdue.
You used the word confidence earlier, and it made me start thinking just the confidence and comfort, I guess, that comes with preparation. How much better equipped do you feel to kind of understand what the portal is now, how it's still kind of evolving to some degree? Do you feel more confident in your approach and that you're getting the results because of that?
I don't feel confident in the portal. I think I feel confident in what we're going to use the portal for, and that is strictly to bolster a position group that is still in need of development. This program, as I said, will be built by freshmen, and development will happen within these walls. We're still not there in particular on the defensive side of the ball. And so you'll see that as we move forward on Friday's announcements in terms of players. But the portal is a very tricky environment. So I think what I'm confident about is that we have a plan, and a plan as to how we're going to use it, the kind of players that we want to bring in out of the portal. But I think it's a moving target still, and you've got to be very, very careful.
Brian, well, as we kind of look ahead, you said there would probably be like mid to high 30s expected in this class. So there's probably, I don't know, somewhere anywhere from 6 to 8 maybe guys who could end up signing, something like that. Between transfers and any other freshmen come February, what positions are you looking at specifically that you might want to target?
Still, you mean?
Yeah.
Yeah.
After today.
Heavy influence on the defensive line. I think you'll see defensive line, defensive backfield as the particular areas that we still need to address as we move forward.
Yeah. I'm just curious, what were your thoughts recruiting JV and Toviano, a guy who kind of kept things close to the vest and announces at the end, but obviously spent a lot of time around your program? Just as the head coach, what were your dealings there?
Well, first of all, you know, recruiting can be, you know, kind of a bittersweet kind of deal where the bitter is actually recruiting the guy because it's so difficult because you're like, man, he's a hard guy to like, and sweet in that he ends up coming your way. This kid is an amazing young man, and it was just enjoyable to spend time with him and his family. So to get the opportunity to recruit somebody that you enjoy being around as much as this young man, and him choose your university, it feels like a double win in that respect because he fits all the criteria we're looking for off the field, in the classroom, and then on the field. He is an elite player. So probably would say that it was extremely enjoyable recruiting him.
Brian, specifically with Zalance Hurd, you mentioned him a little bit earlier, but I mean, this is a five-star, really top, highly recruited player. What do you guys really like about him? What do you kind of envision for him moving forward? And also just in your interactions with him, what do you kind of gather from him early on about just what he's like just as a person?
I like Zalance Hurd. I like his personality. He's extremely confident. I'll share this with you. In recruiting him early on, as we were going through the process, he said, "Coach, you know I'm only going to play left tackle, and that's it." I said, "Well, we got a true freshman, Will Campbell, playing left tackle right now. He's pretty good." He goes, "Well, I've seen Will Campbell play. I played with Will Campbell. I'm playing left tackle." And ever since that time, I was like, I like this kid. Just his confidence, and it wasn't cocky, but it was a confidence, and he's just been that way in the recruiting process. Has a great confidence level, believes in what he's doing and what he can do for this program. And then we put him through the ringer now. I mean, we brought him in here, and we worked him out, and he kept coming back, and we worked him out again, and we got eyes on him, and we watched him, and maybe some of you guys were here, but we put him through the ringer. And he passed every test for us. So feel great about him being in the program.
I'm back.
You're the stats guy. I mean, you know, go figure.
Too much attention to recruiting, I think. I saw some Will Fuller comps on Jaylen Brown. Just your thoughts on Jaylen and just the receiver group, maybe how they all complement each other as different type of players.
Yeah, I actually think you're correct in that, in my assessment. Big play guy, can certainly take the top off of any coverage. Probably more of an X, plays to the field, but elite speed. So we see him as a guy that can do some things that are fairly unique in a sense that really can turn the field over for us. So, he's got to develop, continue to get stronger, I think, and he's working at it. He knows he's got to get stronger in the weight room. But, you know, he's a guy that brings a speed element. We've got guys with really good speed, but he brings an elite speed that's going to be fun. Thank you. Appreciate it being here. We're not going to do a press release. We'll do a press release, not a press conference, because I know you guys will be getting Christmas shopping done. Yeah.